You're constantly told you're fat, you're incompetent, untalented, uncoordinated.
Physical abuse was an everyday experience.
I saw my bone coming out of my foot and I just went into shock.
Jen, Georgia and Aya were once elite gymnasts. They trained at the WA Institute of Sport, also known as WAIS, at different times, but their stories are scarily similar.
What I went through with my well-being, with my mental health, with my physical health, it's not worth it.
Georgia Simpson started at WAIS when she was six. She says her coaches taught her to suppress pain and never show emotion.
If you're crying, they'll, like, just leave you, or they'll tell you to leave the gym.
Georgia Simpson of Team Australia.
She is one of the most elegant gymnasts in the world.
For a decade, Georgia's life was devoted to gymnastics. She trained twice a day and was an aspiring Olympian. But in 2012, that dream came to a grinding halt at a competition in America. Georgia's foot was already injured, but she says her coaches told her to push on anyway.
I thought they would have pulled me out, but they didn't. And I was really confused by that. And I felt like I was kind of at their mercy. Right before my floor, I went into complete panic mode. One of the scariest moments of my life.
She landed and came down horribly wrong. Her ankle was grotesquely bent. There was some blood on the floor that had to be cleaned up.
I stayed very calm. I think I just went into complete, like, don't make a scene mode. I felt like it was my fault. Yes. I felt completely at blame, and I felt like I had failed everybody.
Georgia is confident her career-ending injury could have been avoided, but she says she felt she had no control over her own body.
Emotionally, psychologically, I've had a lot of layers to mend and to heal, and that is an ongoing process.
Georgia is part of the Gymnastics Alliance of Australia, also known as GAA. The group of 130 former gymnasts from the Western Australian Institute of Sport are alleging physical, verbal and sexual abuse by staff from 1987 to 2016.
It's a hands-on sport in that the coaches are required to spot you through skills, but when you have a male coach stretching you with your, you know, legs basically above your head and his groin, you know, on your groin, that's not okay.
Jen, who represented Australia at the 96 Olympics, is one of GAA's leaders.
I remember going through my other schoolmates' bags looking for food. If your weight's not good, if your skin fold's not good, if you don't look good, you'll know about it from the coaches and even from a team selection point of view.
Sport Integrity Australia reviewed the allegations against the artistic gymnastics program at WAIS. It found it is reasonably likely some gymnasts suffered abuse and or harm, and that WAIS policies and procedures did not adequately protect some of the gymnasts, which prompted this apology.
We have listened to you. We are sorry that your experiences were painful rather than enjoyable, and we apologise that elements of the WAIS program failed you.
WAIS, which still runs a host of sports programs, says no one has raised specific allegations against current staff and says it's adopting all recommendations from the review. The Institute insists it has changed with the times. Not so, says Jen.
You have people who are still involved at a high level, like the key decision makers in WAIS who were present at the time that the gymnastics program ran, coaches who coached us throughout the whole period who are still involved at WAIS. We need some new blood in there.
When WAIS dumped the program in 2016, Gymnastics Australia filled the void. The women we spoke to claim the new program is a carbon copy of the old.
The girls who are at WAIS went to that high performance centre, and a lot of the coaches from WAIS also went to the high performance centre. So you can put the same people in a different environment, but the same things are going to happen.
Gymnastics Australia did not respond to our questions about its program, but told us it's taking important steps to transform gymnastics and is committed to ensuring athletes feel safe. Aya Meggs trained at the Institute and Gymnastics Australia's Centre of Excellence.
My coaches, who are no longer employed by WAIS, they still had their desks up in the WAIS building. We still had meetings with our WACE sports psychologists, programs with our dietitian. I experienced the exact same things.
The 21-year-old says gymnastics breeds a culture of fear.
There were hands around the back of my neck that didn't really need to be there, or you weren't caught when you probably should have been. I'd say like a racehorse, in which you are here for performance and everyone that's supporting you is supporting your performance, but they're not really supporting you.
Aya developed a severe eating disorder and claims her coaches pushed her to compete even when she was grossly underweight. It led to her being constantly injured.
You were told that you need to be light because it'll prevent injury and it will help your performance. But your own physiology wasn't really ever taken into account. So I would train, and then after training, I would then go do cardio sessions 3 times a week. And that's when I started purging. I was already abusing laxatives at that point.
Aya says the breaking point for her was when one of her coaches told her to eat less while she was in recovery.
In that culture, it was impossible to recover. I couldn't do it.
Aya, Jan and Georgia are campaigning for ways to pay for mental health support for former athletes. But the main reason they're speaking out is not for their own benefit.
I just really cannot have this happen to someone else.
WA state government, they need to have greater oversight of what's happening. They need to safeguard children who are involved in sport.
Some WACE coaches have realised the impact they've had on athletes.
These are the messages from my coach. I wish I could have been more strong earlier to protect and do better by you all. I know I can't change the past, but for sure I am a different person now.
The women hope that sentiment is shared by coaches everywhere, but now, not later.
I would tell my younger self that you're allowed to feel joy and that you have to make room for joy in your definition for success.
Gee, we really have to applaud Aya, Jen and Georgia for speaking out so bravely the way that they have. They really want to see change in gymnastics in this country. It's such a pity that Gymnastics Australia wouldn't respond to any of our requests to have a conversation with them, because if they want any sort of future for gymnastics in this country, I mean, the press on gymnastics at the moment, both here and in the US, with that very famous case.
And internationally, and has been for a long time.
Yeah.
You know, that there's a... because there's an inherent... I think because the girls have to be light and pretty and attractive in those standard measures, but also have to be strong enough to be able to do these impossible things.
And that moment when Georgia did that tumble turn.
That was very hard to watch.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh,
yeah, the bit I've never understood about it is the culture that they're describing is anti-performance. So I don't even know what they thought they were getting.
It's a culture of fear,
but
by the looks
of
things.
To what end? Do you know what I mean? Like, I just...
Maybe it's a carryover from... because weren't the East Germans traditionally the ones who... and the Russians who owned
Nadia
that?
Comaneci,
and
Romania,
so that is such a kind of totalitarian, cruel regimen under which to train, that maybe they've just adopted that.
Yeah, and you do get coaches from those parts of the world that end up coaching places like Australia. But as Lisa was pointing out, in the United States, where coaches don't... this is some coaches at least, and the relevant person you're talking about didn't have that pedigree.
Right.
So something has happened within that sport that's obviously global, and it is disappointing Gymnastics Australia didn't speak to us. We did a story on this a couple of years ago.
And it's the same.
They have done their review, of course, so we'll see what comes from that. If you want to see full statements from WACE and Gymnastics Australia, you can visit our website, you'll see them there. And if you find yourself in need of help, crisis support is available 24/7 through Lifeline. That's 13 11 14.